We're going back to the basics and create 5 super easy effects that you can do inside Premiere Pro. And with 5 minutes on the clock, let's get started. The first one is the avatar state effect. Simply take a shot of yourself with your eyes wide open. Have someone else blow wind in your face for extra effect. Then inside Premiere, duplicate your shot in a timeline, and with the top selected, we're gonna draw 2 masks around the eyes. Then hit the track forward button for each mask so that it follows your eye movement. Then right click on that layer and choose nest. This way the VR glow effect that we now applied to that clip will glow better around the mask edge. Change the settings to your likings and voila, you're the avatar. For the next one, we're gonna land like a superhero. Put your camera on a tripod and make a fast tilt movement. Let the camera roll, step into the frame, jump and pretend like you've fallen out of the sky. In Premiere, place your tripod shot in a sequence and we're gonna time remap the clip so that your tilt movement goes super fast. On top of there goes your jump clip. Add a cut right before you land. Right click on the left part, go to frame hold options and choose hold on out point. Draw a mask around yourself on the still part and when done with that, nest the clip because we're gonna add the transform effect to it. Create a keyframe for the position and the scale on the end of the clip, then go back in time and push the clip up and scale it down. You might want to go back and forward to get the movement right. Finally, disable composition shutter angle and set one of your own. We found out that 120 gave the best motion blur. The landing itself can use a bigger impact, so for that we're gonna cut a few frames out of it, which creates a jump, but makes the impact stronger. Also, I'm going to time remap the speed of the first part again for that bigger impact. And this is how you can fall from the sky like a superhero. And if you're enjoying these effects, I can highly recommend to check out our brand new Premiere Pro class for advanced users on Skillshare. The class teaches you everything there's to know about Premiere Pro, and if that isn't enough, then why not browse through the tens of thousands of other classes that Skillshare has to offer. Recently, I've been following a class from Simon Sinek, a famous presenter who I've always been looking up to, and it's amazing to see how he designs and structures his presentations. Already from this short 30-minute class, I learned so many new things, and that's what I love about Skillshare. They focus on short, hands-on classes. So even during a lunch break, you can already gain some new insights on a new skill. Now, Skillshare works just like Netflix. With an active subscription, you can watch as many classes as you want. And because they're sponsoring us today, I can give the first 500 students 2 months completely for free. And after that, it costs less than $10 per month. So I can highly recommend checking it out, which you can do by clicking that first link in the description down below. And now let's move on with the reverse water trick, which is really simple actually. Film from a tripod and pour 2 glasses into a container. Now with one hand, you have to mimic like the movements go in reverse. It's very strange at first, but with some practice, you can get it to work. In Premiere, duplicate that clip and time reverse the top layer. Then change the opacity of that clip to 50 so that you can nudge and synchronize it with the bottom clip. Then put the opacity back to 100 and draw a mask through yourself. Feather it a little bit, and that's how you can pour water with one hand, but reverse pour with the other hand. And while everybody knows about your reversing ability, let's teleport out of here. Again, film from a tripod and jump in the air so that your body is completely in the frame. Then walk out of the shot and perhaps kick some objects around you to give some extra motion to it. In Premiere, add that clip where you jump on track 2 and next to that in track 1 the empty shot. We're gonna trim the upper clip a little out and then add a cut where the empty shot starts. Right click on it and choose frame hold. Then take the pen tool and mask around yourself. When done with that, right click and nest the clip. Take the transform effect and apply it to the nested sequence. Animate the scale so that it seems like you're being sucked into another dimension. But make sure to disable composition shutter angle and set one of your own. As an extra touch, we can add an adjustment layer over the effect and apply the turbulent displays effect to it. Set the amount to 50, the size to 1000, and the pinning to pin all locked. Change the evolution so that the distortion pulls your frame inwards. Then animate the amount from 0 to 50, then back to 0, which gives you an extra element when teleporting to another world. And this brings us to the last effect, which we did in a recent video, but many of you guys were asking how we did it. Well, it's actually super easy. Film again from a tripod and throw a ball to a friend, then switch places and now your friend throws the ball to you. Back in Premiere, place the 2 shots of yourself on top of each other, then draw a mask on the top clip. Now nudge that clip until the ball matches with the ball from the shot underneath, and that's it. Seriously, that's it. I told you it was easy. And here's a bonus, if you click on invert mask, you let your friend throw that ball at himself. So you get 2 videos for the price of 1. So go find yourself a masking buddy and throw some balls. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Skillshare for the support. And as always, stay creative. Whew, that was fast. Yeah, and there's still like 20 seconds left or something. So this is more like 5 effects in Premiere under 4 minutes 40. Yeah. Fast.